What's going on, Aurora Alliance, and welcome back to a brand new Star Wars Battlefront video. In today's video, I am going to be talking about one of, if not the best, weapon in Star Wars Battlefront for long-range combat. This gun also works on the small game modes just as well, but only if you stick to the outskirts of the map or have a fast enough trigger finger and accuracy to compete with the blaster pistols. So, it has been brought to my attention that a lot of you guys thought that the EE3 was the best weapon in Star Wars Battlefront. So I went ahead and tested it out over a few hours and found that to be relatively true, but again, it still can be beaten by other weapons depending on the situation. For example, at short range it can be beaten by blaster pistols due to their fire rate and amount of damage dealt. I do think that there are a lot of good guns in Star Wars Battlefront, so I will get around to reviewing them all. So let's start off with what I found when I was using the EE3 Burst Fire Blaster Rifle. The gun is amazing at medium to long range, and you are likely to win most gunfights as long as your accuracy is on point and you can control the bursts evenly, not to cause too much recoil, as it seems to often kill in 2 to 3 bursts and even quicker if you can get headshots. Close range, the gun seems to lose a lot of appeal because if you don't have a fast enough trigger finger and end up missing blaster bolts, then you will be outgunned, as this gun is about hitting every bolt in the burst to achieve the maximum potential. But again, it is not impossible to win a lot of gunfights at close range, as long as you don't miss bolts and can fire bursts at a reasonable rate, then you should be fine in close quarter combat. Now, as always, we get into the real statistics of the gun. The EE3 only has a pretty standard maximum damage at 21, with a minimum damage of 12, which can make it fit in with the average assault rifle like the A2AEC in Star Wars Battlefront. But it can actually fire a lot more shots before it overheats in comparison to the T21B. The EE3 can fire 23 shots before overheating, whereas the T21B can only fire 7, but does have a much higher damage. The T21B can fire 180 rounds per minute, and the EE3 can only fire about 120 rounds per minute, but because it is a burst fire weapon, it can fire 800 rounds per minute, which is insane compared to the T21B. Finally, the EE3 has a lot less recoil in comparison to the T21B, so it is a lot easier to handle, but requires more skill because you have to hit all shots in the burst for it to have the best results, where the T21B has to just hit 2 to 3 shots and it kills, but still takes a lot of accuracy skill to pull off. So in conclusion, I do believe that the EE3 is possibly one of the best weapons at medium to long range in Star Wars Battlefront, but it does require a bit more skill than most of the weapons in the game, as you need to hit every shot in the burst to achieve maximum damage. If you have incredible accuracy and feel like you are a more laid-back, medium to long range player in Star Wars Battlefront, then I would definitely recommend using the EE3. But if you feel like accuracy is not your strongest asset, then maybe this weapon is not actually for you. So guys, comment down in the section below what you found when you used the EE3, and smash a like if you've enjoyed this video. Also, let me know which gun you want to do next. I know a lot of people want me to review the T21 and the T21B, so I will get around to that at some point. Subscribe to be kept up to date with all things Star Wars, and may the Force be with you.